Number one, lot of the shastras, even the normal shastras, were revealed by the seers, their preceptors, only by penance and austerity. Even meteorology, even the Rasarnava, the alchemy, the Vaimanika Shastra, Bharadwaja in aeronautics, even the mundane sciences, they have been revealed by our ancestors through penance austerity. And this samadhi is ecstatic trance. And the ecstatic trance is a divine bliss, and that is divine experience, and that does not come for the rescue of the society and shastras. Tapa alochane, that is the dhatu. If somebody is interested in the revelation of a knowledge for relief of a society, rescue of a society, they go in penance for thousands of years and get those things. How Sayanacharya, Bhaskaracharya and Aryabhatta, they could exactly derive at the speed of light, the diameter of the earth, distance between earth and moon, earth and sun, how they can derive these things without the support of any scientific meteorological experiments or the instruments which are available now. Exactly they could do that because of their penance and austerity. That type of contemplative lineage, that is Upasana Parampara, has been totally discarded. Now the Ayurveda, present Ayurveda, that is just with materia medica, pathology, physiology and anatomy. Now the Ayurveda is very much limited. It is a very wonderful question. It is an eye-opener, at least for the believers, the astikas of the Ayurvedas, who are not treating it as just a material or a medical treatise. They must consider it. It is a very important subject. Number one, all the Vedic scriptures are on basis of nine qualities. Yesterday, day before yesterday, while defining a Brahmana or Rishi, I gave this explanation. It is very much essential to represent this here also. One thing, each and everybody is processed by samskaras. So the first blessing or benefit for a person is samskara. After the samskaras is over, the person gets into swadhyaya, resumption of Vedas. So first the person is purified by refinement, the process of refinement. Then he enters into swadhyaya, recitation of Vedas. Then after the swadhyaya is over, or in the process of swadhyaya, he develops certain qualities. They are known as shamadamadi guna. If you enter into swadhyaya, what is the benefit? Shama and dama, external and internal restraint. In the process of shama and dama, you will get lot of hindrance. To balance that, you have to develop tapas and brahmacharya. Tapas and brahmacharya will be disturbed by lot of factors. To remove those obstacles, you must get into achara and anushtana. So a person with samskara must rest in swadhyaya. Samskara and swadhyaya must take resort into shama dhamadi guna. Samskara, Swadhyaya and Shamadamadi Guna must get into Tapas and Brahmacharya. Samskara, Swadhyaya, Shamadamadi Guna, Tapas and Brahmacharya must follow Achara and Anushtana for protection. It is like the sealed cup or a well-packed, air-packed cup which preserves it from vaporization or any other external disturbance. So a person with this Samskara, Swadhyaya, Shamadamadi Guna, Tapas Brahmacharya and Achara Anushtana will get only real bhakti. Whatever we have bhakti is just a solace or inner comfort or artificial comfort or unknown fear. It is not bhakti at all. The real bhakti comes from this product. If a person has bhakti with the above requisites, then only he will indulge into real havana, pujana, yajana, bhojana, bhajana. He will get into this process. That person only will produce kripa, audarya and other good gunas. That person will get only tejas and shakti. And he is only a rishi and brahmana. He can only help the world. So, samskara, swadhyaya, shamadamadi guna, tapa, brahmacharya, achara nushtana, bhakti, havana pujana, then audari kripadi guna, which evinces in the form of tejashan shakti, radiation, permeation and vibration, vitalization, resurrection of the universal forces. Actually, you must understand that helmet is for those people who are having these two-wheelers. If you are not having this thing at all, what is the use of mere helmet? Why you are wearing like an astronaut? So likewise, Ayurveda is a Upaveda. So a person who has mastered Ayurveda must have mastered Veda. After Veda Sikshana only it has been advised. Swadhyayo adhyetavyaha. First you must go into Swadhyaya. As soon as your Vedic erudition education is over in these three processes, one is the process of recitation, second is the process of ritualization, third is the process of realization. If these things are over, then only you must come to the sublimes. There are three major sublimes. One is yoga, second is Ayurveda, third is Jyotisha. Jyotisha includes Vastu. Now we are seeing lot of people, dissociated with the Vedic wisdom. They don't know anything about the Vedas, having come for the rescue of the society through astrological predictions, through Ayurvedic medications, and through mystic prescriptions. How it is possible? They can get only the peripheral benefits. They can get only the peripheral benefits. See, we are taking all good things and we are throwing this, just as you are going to peel off the oranges or other fruits, you are going to consume the fleshy portions and throwing the skins outside. That will be consumed by animals and some other unwanted people in these fields. Likewise, whatever that is thrown unwanted, that is a peripheral portion which is just like a corpse portion without the spirit inside, is consumed by the modern people, and now they are serving the society. Whenever the Vedic society creates, according to the norms and requirements of the society, after Vedic knowledge is acquired, if they practice yoga, they will be 200% successful. Not only yoga, Ayurveda and also Jyotisha. Now it is a pitiable situation of the society that person just knowing 27 nakshatras and their names, just immediately they start with a board that they are doing astrological research. 60% and 40% of the people even don't know the names. So let us create an integrated system of Vedic knowledge with yoga, Ayurveda and Jyotisha, which is going to really serve the society. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.